A farmer, David, lived in a village called Shiprock. He used to serve his land with dedication. He, along with his wife, used to work hard in their field. He was known as father in entire village. Mother Nature was also happy with her. His fields used to yield good crops. Villagers used to respect him a lot.
Father is such a good person, but God is not fair because he has not blessed him with a child, whereas some people have lots of children. What a justice of God.
You remain sad because you don't have any children, isn't it? Do you know what I think?
What do you think?
It is possible that Mother Nature chose us to serve her because if we have children, we will pay less attention to her. That is why we don't have kids. Now we will look after our field just like our children.
Phoebe and Father go to sleep after having dinner. The next day, they plow their field properly. This goes on for many days. Both husband and wife didn't have kids. One fine day, Phoebe finds that she is pregnant. Her health improved day by day. But she did not tell this to her husband. She used to stay happy the whole day, which is why her husband started to like her. One fine day.
What happened, Phoebe? You are getting fat day by day. What's the matter?
It's nothing. I mean...
Oh, come on.
You are going to be a father. And that's why my complexion has improved and I'm feeling better.
What? Are you telling the truth?
Yes, that's true. I want to eat the vegetable made of banana flour. Will you bring the flour for me?
Of course, why not? While coming back from the fields tomorrow, I will get the flowers of banana.
Yes, it's fine.
Father looks for banana flour in the village next day. But he did not find it. Now, he plans to go to the forest and goes there. But he could not find that flower there as well. He was walking in the forest and right then, he saw an amazing thing in front of him. He saw that a hen is walking with a deer and there is a bird also.
How is this possible? A hen and a bird with a deer?
Father was staring at this scene when the deer came to him and started talking.
Hey, what are you staring at? What has happened to you?
Nothing. I am surprised seeing different creatures with you.
Farmer friend, what brings you here?
I am looking for a banana tree. I couldn't find them in the field and so I thought I might get it here in the forest, Uncle dear.
Don't call me your uncle. I am like your son-in-law.
Okay, fine. But I don't have a daughter. Then how can you be my son-in-law?
Hey, father, not now. But you are going to be a father in 4-5 months.
Yes, but how did you know?
I know everything. If you have a girl child, you will give her to me. And if it is a boy, you can keep him. If you agree to this condition, I can get you the flower.
It's okay. You can get me the flower.
Now, father didn't have an option. He said yes to the deer. Now, the deer takes him deep into the forest and gets banana flower in a bag to hand over to him. Father brings the bag home and prays silently to have a boy. Few months pass and Phoebe gives birth to a beautiful girl. The deer comes to know about this and so, one fine day, the deer came to their door.
You had a daughter and as per your promise, you will have to give this child to me. I have come today to take her.
Hey dear, please let me spend some time with my daughter. I have had a child after such a long time and you are talking about taking her away with you. Take her with you when she grows up.
Okay, but after she grows up, I will be the one to take her.
Father gets relaxed and lives happily with his daughter. Her daughter Milane is grown up now. He educated her. Then after a long time, the same deer comes back to their house. But this time also, father makes an excuse after seeing the deer.
Father-in-law, now no more excuses. You will have to give me your daughter.
Okay, I will give you. But how can I give you like this? You come day after tomorrow. I will call the priest and marry my daughter to you. Then you can take her with you.
Deer goes away happily to the forest. Then an idea comes in father's mind. He says to Phoebe,
I am planning to send Milane to her grandmother's house. The deer will not come to know about her. And our Milane will stay with us.
It looks fine. We will do this way. You take her to her grandmother's house.
The other day, father takes his daughter and starts early in the morning. They have to cross a dense forest on the way. Both of them got tired by walking and they sit in some place. Right then, Milane saw a beautiful garden and she says to her father,
Daddy, can I go and pluck some beautiful flowers from the garden?
Father never refused his daughter anything.
Okay, you can go, but come back soon after plucking the flower.
Yes, Daddy, I will come back soon.
Now Milene gets busy plucking flowers and enters deep into the garden gradually. She sees a cave there. She enters the cave. She sees a deer inside the cave. Now she starts walking after the deer. This was deer's trap. Now Milene comes to a palace. Meanwhile, father started looking for his daughter. Time passed, but he could not find her anywhere. Now he became anxious. Deer was the prime minister and the king of that kingdom was Madox. His people were quite less in number. Because of the curse of a witch, all the people there became other living creatures. The hen was Deer's minister and the bird was his maid. The deer's palace was very beautiful. Now Milene came to that palace with Deer.
Come, let me show you an amazing thing.
Now what amazing thing is left for me to see?
The deer takes off his clothes and suddenly he turns into a handsome man. Milene looks at him surprised.
You are a human being like us.
We are just like you. The only difference is that we have four legs and you have two legs.
But when you are a human being, why do you disguise like a deer then?
There is a witch in our village. She converted us into creatures. So until she is alive, we will remain like this.
Now Milene started living with that deer in that palace. Many days passed. One day the deer had to go far away for a long time and Milene was to stay alone in the house. One fine day, someone knocked at the door of their palace. Milene thought it must be the deer and she opened the door. She saw that an old lady has come with a girl.
Who are you and why have you come here?
I am Deer's aunt and this is my daughter.
Now the old lady and the girl started living in the house. Milene took good care of them. But there was a peculiar thing about the girl and the old lady. When Milene slept, they secretly ate food. This goes on for some days. One night, Milene feels thirsty and she comes out of her room to drink water. When she enters the kitchen, she sees that the old lady is sitting with a big plate in front of her. There is rice and pieces of meat on it. And she's eating that as if she has been hungry for days. Seeing all this, Milene gets frightened.
We will roast and fry this girl tomorrow and eat her up. Yes, tomorrow we will have a good hospitality.
Milene listens to them and runs away to her room.
This old aunt is not Deer's aunt. She is the witch who had cursed, who is going to eat me up. Now what should I do?
The next day, that old lady has to go out for some work. She leaves the small girl in the house.
Keep an eye on this girl. Make sure she doesn't run away. Remember, we have to fry and eat her.
Yes, I know.
Milene listens to them and drops her veil outside. Milene sends that girl to bring that veil back. As soon as the girl goes out of the palace, Milene closes the doors and windows of the palace. She goes to the kitchen and checks the witch's bag. She finds lot of herbs, balm, and some dolls in that bag. She gets frightened after seeing them. After some time, the witch returns and eats that girl up in anger. Milene sees all this from her terrace. She gets frightened and drops the bomb on the witch that she had found in the witch's bag. There is a big explosion and the witch dies. Now, Milene closes herself in a room and does not come out for 3-4 days. After a few days, someone knocks the door.
Who is it?
Hey, this is your father, child.
Whosoever you are, you cannot fool me.
Hey, child, this is me. You were lost in the garden. I came here looking for you.
Milene opens the door hesitatingly and seeing her father hugs him and starts crying. Her father takes her back home. After the death of the witch, the entire kingdom gets free from the curse and everyone comes back in human form like before.
Long time ago, there lived a king. There was a unique tree in his kingdom. It was different because it had apples made of gold. A loyal gardener of the king used to count the apples daily and inform the king. But one day, an apple got stolen. Hearing this from the gardener, the king became angry.
The thief will be punished.
That night, the gardener sent his elder son to guard the apples, but he fell asleep in the middle of the night. Next day, one more apple was gone.
Tonight, I will send my other son to guard.
Okay.
It was night and gardener's other son also fell asleep. Next day, another apple was less. Now, the gardener's third and youngest son took the responsibility. Night fell. Gardener's third son started his work.
Come, apple thieves. Come now and try.
After some time, late into the night, suddenly some noise started coming from the leaves. He saw that a golden bird was plucking the apple. Gardener's son took aim without wasting any time and shot an arrow, but it couldn't harm the bird at all. Only a feather from its tail fell down and the bird flew away. The golden feather was presented to the king the next day and all ministers were called to the court. Everyone saw that this feather was more precious than all the king's belongings.
What use is just one feather to me? I want the whole bird. Who is so brave in my court to bring the whole bird in front of me?
Gardener's eldest son came forward and took the responsibility.
Well done.
Gardener's eldest son went to the forest in the search of this golden bird. He was going through the forest and suddenly he saw a fox.
Huh?
The boy took his arrow and aimed it at the fox.
Don't kill me. I can help you.
Huh?
You are searching the golden bird, right?
Huh?
Listen to me carefully. If you walk straight from here till evening, you will reach a village. There you will find a very big and beautiful palace. And there will be a hut in front of the palace. You must choose the hut to stay during the night.
Gardener's son started thinking. He thought that it must be a trap. So he shot at the fox. But he missed. And the fox ran away. Gardener's son went ahead. Then he saw the palace and the hut exactly like the fox had told him. He saw that people near the palace were dancing, having fun, and eating good food. On the other hand, there was sadness and poverty. After seeing this, he thought,
I will be a fool of all time if I go towards the hut.
That's why he went towards the palace where he ate, drank, and rested. He had forgotten about the bird and his kingdom. Time passed by, but the eldest son didn't come back. So the second son went to do the work. He also did the same thing. He found the fox, and she gave him the same advice. But when he reached the village, his brother called him towards the palace. Just like his brother, he also forgot about the bird and the kingdom. Time passed by. Now, the youngest son also wanted to go and search for the golden bird.
Let me go, father.
But the gardener didn't want to lose his youngest son like his other sons.
Father, I will come back. Believe me. And let me go. Okay. But take care of yourself.
Gardener's youngest son went into the forest. On his way, he found the same fox that had met his brothers.
Huh?
The fox gave him the same advice.
If you want to reach your destination, go to the hut.
Thank you, friend, for the advice.
Sit on my tail. You will reach there fast.
He reached the village quickly and spent the night in the hut. In the morning, the fox came back and gave one more advice.
Now move straight ahead. You will find a fort where many soldiers will be sleeping in deep sleep. You have to ignore them and go inside the fort. You will find a room there with the golden bird in a wooden cage. There will be another cage made of gold. Don't even try to exchange the cage, or you will regret later.
The fox spread his tail again, and the young boy sat on it. Both of them reached the fort. the boy went inside the fort and saw the room and the bird of gold, as told by the fox.
Keeping this beautiful bird in this wooden cage is not good.
As soon as the boy opened the door of the wooden cage, the bird started shouting. All the soldiers woke up because of the noise. The boy was made prisoner.
Huh?
Next morning, he was presented in the court. There, he was sentenced to death.
My lord, please be kind to me.
I will leave you only on one condition. Go and bring me the golden horse who runs fast like a storm. Then I will forgive you and also give the golden bird to you.
He started his journey again. On the way, he found his friend the fox.
You saw what happened because you didn't follow my advice. You are a good boy. That's why I will help you find the golden horse. You go straight ahead and you will see a fort. The horse will be standing there in his tent. His caretaker will be in deep sleep. Free the horse from there silently. But don't forget to put the old leather saddle on him. Don't take the golden saddle.
Everything was going fine. Seeing the horse, the boy said,
I will give him the golden saddle. He deserves that.
As soon as the boy touched the golden saddle, the caretaker woke up. Soldiers came running and arrested him. Next day, he was sentenced to death again. He again asked for forgiveness.
I will let you live if you can bring the beautiful princess to me. Then you can keep the bird and the horse.
The boy started his journey. He found the fox again.
If you had taken my advice, the bird and the horse would have been with you. But I will help you again. You will reach a palace ahead from here. You will find the princess there. Take her hand. She goes to take a bath at midnight. She will tell you the way then. But remember, don't let her go to her parents to say goodbye.
The fox and the boy reached the palace. The boy did exactly what the fox had told him. At midnight, he stepped out with the princess. But the girl started crying and said that she wanted to meet her father. The boy finally agreed. But as soon as she came to meet her father, the boy was taken prisoner.
You cannot take my daughter until you break that mountain in 8 days.
That mountain was so huge that he couldn't do it alone. Even after 7 days, he couldn't even break a small portion of the mountain. He sat down disappointed. Suddenly, his friend, the fox, came there.
You go to sleep. I will finish up your work.
And in the morning, the mountain was gone. The king became happy and gave the princess to him. The young boy and the princess departed from there. On their way, they met the fox again.
Now you take all three of them, the princess, the horse, and even the bird.
Really? But how?
Listen carefully. You go to the king and hand over the princess. He will become very happy. Then you sit on the horse and say goodbye to him. Shake hands with the princess in the last. And then quickly sit on the horse and run as fast as you can. Then go to the next fort where the bird lives. I will wait outside with the princess. You show the horse to the kind king. Then he will bring the bird outside. You can ask him to show the bird to you. As soon as you get the bird, you leave quickly from there.
It all happened just like the fox had said.
Thank you, my dear friend. I could not have done this without you. Please tell. What can I do for you?
If so, then please kill me.
What? I cannot do that. You are my friend.
Okay, whatever you wish. But I will give you an advice. Always remember two things. Don't help anyone on your way back and give any money to anybody. And remember, don't sit near the river.
Riding with the princess, he reached the village where his two brothers were held. Two men were going to be hanged there. He saw that these two men were his brothers, who were now turned into thieves.
Wait, take all my money, but leave my brothers.
After rescuing his brothers, all of them were going through the forest. Then, both the brothers decided to sit near the river and eat something. During this, youngest son forgot the advice of the fox. And before he could do anything, both his brothers pushed him into the river. With the princess, the horse, and the bird, they reached the king of their own kingdom.
Long live the king! Our king, we have brought the golden bird. We won him with our hard work.
Then a royal feast was prepared. But the horse didn't eat anything. The bird didn't sing. And the princess started crying. The youngest son had fallen into the river, but luckily the river was dry. But the river bank was so steep that he was not able to climb above. Then his friend, the fox, came there again.
If you had remembered what I told you, then this would have not happened. Still, you are my friend. I can't leave you here. So hold on to my tail quickly. Your brothers have left guards for you. They will kill you as soon as they see you.
Then the boy dressed himself as a poor person and reached the king's court. As soon as the horse saw him, he started eating. The bird started singing. The princess stopped crying. Then he went to the king and told him the whole story. Both brothers were punished. And the youngest son got the princess again. When the king died, the youngest son of the gardener was chosen as the king of the kingdom. After a few days, he went towards the forest. There, he met his friend, the fox. She again requested the boy to kill her.
My dear friend, please help me by killing me. Please help me get my freedom.
The youngest son agreed with a sad heart. As soon as the fox died, she turned into a man. That man was the brother of the princess, who had been lost for many years.